Model of humility. Humility comes from the Latin word humilis, which literally means low. There are several definitions of humility, and they all have to do with lowliness. Saint Bernard defines it as a virtue by which man, knowing himself as he truly is, abases himself. The Blessed Virgin Mary, in becoming the Mother of God, is the most exalted of all God's creatures. Yet, she is the most humble of all after Christ. So great was her humility that in one of the revelations to Saint Bridget, the virtue humility was called Mary. According to biblical accounts of Mary's life, especially in Luke's Gospel account, chapter 1 from verse 38 down, her response to Angel Gabriel's salutation and greeting, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord, let it be done to me according to your word," reveals her humble trust in God. Her going to serve Elizabeth for 3 months reveals her humble disposition to serve. When upon her arrival, Elizabeth made to praise her by calling her blessed of all women, Mary acknowledged the truth of her blessedness, but in all humility, referring her praise to God by rendering the Magnificat, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. He has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Henceforth, all ages will call me blessed." When she gave birth to her godson in a stable for lack of space, she wrapped him in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger, humbly accepting the circumstance she found herself without grumbling. The serpent in Genesis 3:5 lured Eve and consequently Adam to disobedience by making them want to equal to God. But Mary crushed its head with her humility because she wouldn't even exalt herself among humans, not to mention before God. If we are to be true children of God, we should follow in the humble footsteps of Mary, because it is difficult to be holy if we are not humble. Mary, most humble, pray for us.